Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you the use of super keyword in Java. Before starting, you can note my information. You can connect with me by following these details. If you want to watch programming related videos, you can subscribe my YouTube channel by clicking on bottom right corner of this video. You can download my app TechImage that is available on Google Play. Now coming on to the topic. For demonstration purpose, I am using Eclipse IDE. Here I have implemented a code for you. You can see that I have implemented class A first, which is having a variable I. Inside class A, I have implemented first method, which is set. It is receiving an argument into X variable, and that X variable is assigned into I. Then show method is defined, which is displaying value of I on console. So this is definition of class A. Now, second class B is defined, which is inheriting class A. Here, class A is working as superclass and class B is working as subclass. B class is also having attribute whose name is I. So in case if you have two variables, one in superclass and one in subclass, and both variables are sharing same name, then for distinguish those variables, with superclass variable you can use super keyword, and with subclass variable you don't have to use anything. Here in set method, two values are received into x and y. X is assigned into super.i, which is referring to superclass, and I equals to y, it belongs to subclass. Similarly, inside show method, super.show, it is calling show of superclass. And the system.out.println will be displaying value of I, which is available in subclass. So friends, with the help of this two definition, class A and class B, you might have understood the relation between these two classes. And if you want to access members of superclass, right now here, class A, we can use super keyword. Now third class, which is test, inside test class, main method is defined. Here, object of B class is created, which is calling set and show methods of B class. While set and show methods of B class are called, they internally will be calling members of class A, because we have used super keywords inside set and show of subclass, that is B class. Now I am saving this code and I am executing this code. You can see the output. A's I equals to 10 and B's I equals to 20. This is happening because of super keyword. Now if I pass different values, 200 and 400. This 200 will be assigned into this X, which is passing into superclass, and 400 will be assigned into Y, which is assigning into subclass I variable. So here again, output will be 200 and 400. You can see A's I is 200 and B's I is 400. So friends, if you want to share members of superclass with subclass, or you can say if you want to access members of superclass into subclass, then you can use super keyword for that purpose. I hope you have understood the use of super keyword in Java with the help of this simple demonstration. If you want to understand this concept well, you can implement this at your own. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can connect with me by following these details which are available in front of you. Thank you for watching this video.